of the Lord.
It's the hand of the Lord that's upon me.
Oh,
oh.
God bless you, saints and friends. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we're rejoicing and ever so glad to be in it. We greet you in divine love, and we welcome you to the City of Greater Works. Welcome to Resurrection Sunday. First, I would like to take a moment and thank God for all of our servant leaders who served Lady Brenda Neal on yesterday. I thank you for your faithful service. You did it with class and hospitality. You did it the greater way. And I want to thank you, especially on behalf of Lady Neal, Brother Patrick, and all of those that are related. They give you their greatest thank yous. And I thank you as well. Go Greater Works. Well, saints of God, this is the day that we pray that you have been prayerful about, and that is First Fruit Sunday. We're so excited this morning to be able to share our seeds of faith to the Lord in thankful sacrifice and humility for the things that he has won for us through his resurrection. Bless his holy name. Some of you may give your first fruit this Sunday, and others on tonight at our evening service. We encourage you to hold on to it and come back tonight. We're asking all saints tonight that have it within your grasp and your attire to wear white on tonight to our 7 p.m. service. We're going to give our first fruit giving publicly, and we're going to do a special enactment of communion. The Bible declares that Pilate had asked for a basin of water. And when he got that basin of water, he put his hands in that basin. And he says these words, "I find no fault in Jesus." What an amazing testimony. And on tonight, we're going to do that enactment. Every saint tonight individually is going to pass through the line of our brethren. And you're going to have your hands washed and dried. You're going to be anointed with oil and prayed for. And the critical question that I want you to ponder on between now and tonight is this. Do you and God got any mishaps? Is there anything that you went through in life, even recently? It could be something as simple as struggling in life. Money's funny. Change is strange. Family's acting crazy. Children won't act right. And sometime you look to heaven or to ask God, do you care? I mean, after all, Peter is on the boat and he's asking this critical question, Lord, do you care that we perish in the storm? And sometime along the journey, you can find fault in God. Listen, I've been there. I know how that feels. But on tonight, I really want to ask you tonight, when you're getting ready to walk before me tonight, I want to ask you the critical question. Are you and God okay? And before you take communion tonight, I am praying that the Lord will reveal and that you would be honest, that there is nothing that you go through in life where you cannot burp out, the Lord is good all the time. Be prayerful about it tonight, and I'll see you tonight at 7 o'clock. Well, saints and friends, no Bible class or midweek service is on this week. We have been running tirelessly through the month of March. And I think all of our servant leaders would say that a week of break would just be needful for us all. And I do understand that. And so there's no midweek services on this week. God bless you. Saints of God, we are encouraging all of our parents and all of our young people to please stop by the bookstore. We have pre-ordered your Pardon My Swag shirts, and they are in. And we want to settle that because we're getting ready for Impact Conference 2018. We're getting ready to order banners and shirts, and our leadership team is gathering together who's going to be the initial team that will work it and work with volunteers. We're excited about it. It's going to start with our core of youth workers and expand throughout the city. We are partnering with Second Baptist Pastor Jarvis. I have a visit with him. He's excited about it as well in their youth department. And we are looking to pack the City of Greater Works out. And so we want to make sure all business is final as relates to internally our house. And so please, parents, if you pre-ordered a shirt or made your request that you wanted a shirt, a Park My Swag shirt, we want you to get it today. It is our heart that on Fourth Sunday, we have a rally service with several youth groups from around the city. And Second Baptist and other groups are getting ready to come to a pre-rally service at our Sunday Night Live. That's right, 6 o'clock is our prayer. We're confirming all things, and we will make sure that we make the public announcement next week that all things are in place. But what we're doing is we're rallying our children and some of the youth groups of this community and letting them know how serious we are about Impact Conference. We've already sent the quiz bowl questions to many youth pastors and encouraged them to have several of their people to look at it by PDF and see if they would like to compete. I am up in the ante, and I want our Children of Greater Works to represent very well. And everywhere I go and everybody I've been talking to is I want the competition to be intense like never before. Praise the Lord. Calling all seasoned saints, praise the Lord, 53 and older, we're asking that you would come out and be a part of what we are already planning, and that is Seasoned Saints Day on April the 14th. Next week on Thursday at 5:30, Lady Kim is going to be meeting with all of our senior saints. And we're so excited and asking that you would come and be a part of our annual choir. We're so excited that Saturday, the 14th, the Mother's Luncheon will take place here at the City of Greater Works in our Fellowship Hall. The menu's already set. The speaker has already been confirmed. And that is none other than Dr. Emma Kelly Rose. She's going to be speaking about leaving the legacy and what we've really been talking about in the Jewish Phenomenon series during our midweek service. She's going to come and tell the mothers how vital it is to leave a legacy and what they do before children, their conversation, their deeds, their actions that you're responsible for in the service and ministry of our Lord Jesus. You don't want to miss. Help us make this a grand event. God bless you. I want to take a moment and thank Brother Terry and the youth team. Thank our media, our music department, our staff, and all the leaders that were vital, and especially all of our members who donated eggs or anything for this special day. We thank you that Easter is very vital to us. Resurrection Sunday is the hallmark of all Christianity. Again, we thank God for Mother Mary and our brethren, and for those who came to the breakfast. We thank God for you. We just know that today is worth celebrating. And we thank all of the work that goes into it. I mean, after a while, you know, many come just on Sunday morning and think it's just poof, there it is. But that's not so. Okay. And we thank God for all that helped make it happen. And how you died upon the tree. You are my number one friend. Yes, you are. Well, saints of God, that's our prayer list. We ask that you would govern yourselves according to all of the announcements. And remember what I always tell you. Whatsoever you do in word or deed, do it all to the glory of God. I look forward to seeing you tonight. We're going to get ready to sow our first fruit offering and share communion and a powerful word. You don't want to miss. Come casual with your white on. Amen. If you don't have that, at least bring a white hanky. Because we're going all the way in. The band is ready. The choir is ready. I'm ready to see you all tonight. Praise the Lord. God bless you is my prayer. And enjoy the rest of the service.